Yeah, so we'll switch gears from infection to imaging and therapy of thyroid cancer. So the objective of my talks are very straightforward. We want to use a Theranostic approach, the integration of diagnostics to guide the therapy. Therefore, I will present how useful the pretreatment scans are for managing thyroid cancer and why they need to be performed, because based on the information on the diagnostic scan, we can change the postoperative staging as compared to histopathology-based staging alone. It changes the postoperative risk stratification, which has become a very important component of evaluation of patients with thyroid cancer. And basically, we receive these referrals for radioactive iodine treatment based on the risk stratification. And ultimately, doing these diagnostic scans change patient management. The result is an individualized therapeutic prescription for patients with advanced thyroid cancer. Due to the introduction of the 2015 ATA guidelines, a lot of low-risk and low-to-intermediate-risk patients are not referred for ablation. Therefore, we have actually to treat patients that are considered at high risk for recurrent or metastatic thyroid cancer. These are actually the patients that are preferentially referred for radioactive iodine treatment. The second objective of my talk, to address when the pretreatment scans need to be performed, and practically it's before patient receives therapy. So the ideal, in the ideal world, following the Theranostic principles, no patient should receive internal radiation therapy unless we have a pretreatment scan for planning. Not only planning the therapy and adjusting the dose, but also as a baseline for assessing treatment outcome. So due to these new ATA guidelines that have become very prominent in the referral pattern, they clearly impacted the way we manage these patients. Most patients with low intermediate recurrence risk are no longer referred for ablation. And therefore, in this particularly selected patient population of intermediate to high risk, diagnostic pretreatment radioactive iodine scans are very useful to detect iodine avid regional and distant metastatic disease and guide our management regarding dose adjustment. The third part of my talk is to address how to perform these scans. There has been considerable review and progress. I will review the progress in gamma camera technology that makes possible acquisition of spectacular diagnostic fusion SPECT/CT images with low diagnostic activity of 1 to 2 millicurie, which is unlikely to produce a clinical significant stunning effect. So we have studies that have shown that if the therapeutic dose is administered early, within a 72-hour window of pretreatment scan, and the post-therapy scan are done early, within 2 to 4 days of treatment, stunning it's practically is not visible, is not observed. And I know that there has been a lot of discussion in our field in the past 30 years, but probably it has been the observational phenomenon of stunning likely was due to the true cytocidal effect of the high diagnostic doses between 5 to 10 millicurie that have been used in the past, and also to the fact that post-therapy scans have been performed late, usually at 7 to 10 days, in the studies that reported stunning. And therefore, by 7 to 10 days, we already had a significant therapeutic effect with loss of these iodine cells, that is apoptosis and loss of therapeutic iodine in the urine.